useful level is the level which we need the most. Without cities, society founders very, very quickly. During the ice storm, within a few minutes of electricity and water, etc., being shut down, our city started to crumble, and so did Montreal, and so did Kingston. That's how important cities are. And when people go to war, they tend to go to war actually against cities. Look at the war in Iraq, I think 400,000 Iraqis have died. I think that's a lot more than the number of soldiers that have passed away. So cities around the world have been at the forefront of the peace movement. We are participants in Mayors for Peace. I had the good fortune to go with Debbie Grisdale down to New York with Mayors for Peace, where we demonstrated and presented in the Assembly of the United Nations for the disarmament, the nuclear disarmament of the planet. And I was really surprised, because this was just after the World Trade Center attack, that most insistent mayors against nuclear weapons were the mayors from the United States. And I remember one speech in particular from San Diego, where the mayor said, "Look, have you really thought about what happens if we get one very small nuclear bomb going off in San Diego? We have 50,000 containers through our port every day, and those containers spread out across North America. That port, when it shuts down, will affect most of the western part of the continent." And he said also, Los Angeles is our closest neighbor. There'll probably be a 10 kilometer or 10 mile square area which will be uninhabitable for many years. So when a mayor or a council thinks about weapons, whether they're tanks, whether they're AK-47s, whether they're cluster bombs, whether they're mines, they're thinking of the things that are going to destroy their city, which they work so hard with all their communities to build up and make prosper. So cities around the world have led the battle against weapons, and those weapons sales should not be occurring in a city facility. I don't think New York would allow that. I don't think the City of London would allow that. And you know what? It's a blot and a blight on our history. On our we are known around the world as a peaceful people, and Ottawa, the capital, is known as a peaceful place. The tulips celebrate the liberation of Holland and the friendship we have with the people of Holland. The end of the Ottawa landmines is around the world, the place we finally managed to bury most of the horror of landmines. And every time that armament thing comes forward on the press and goes around the world, it sends a signal that somehow we have lost our way. And we must send the signal to City Council that we haven't lost our way. We know exactly where we want to go. We want to go towards peace and against war.
Merci, Kai.